తప్పిగొన్న తుప్పివలి ఆరాటపడుతుంది నా హృదయం ఎండిన నేలవలే వేచియున్నది నా మనసు
పడుతుంది నా హృదయం
In the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, in order to participate in this Holy Eucharist, let us recall to our mind the failures we have committed and ask God's pardon and forgiveness. I confess to Almighty God
and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, to my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. May the working of your mercy, O Lord, we pray, direct our hearts aright, for without your grace, we cannot find favor in your sight. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
For the first reading, kindly turn to page 882 from the Old Testament, page 882. Jeremiah chapter 11, verses 18 to 20. The Lord made it known to me, and I knew. Then thou didst show me their evil deeds, but I was like a gentle lamb led to the slaughter. I did not know it was against me they devised schemes, saying, let us destroy the tree with its fruit. Let us cut him off from the land of the living, that his name be remembered no more. But, O Lord of hosts, who judgest righteously, who triest the heart and the mind, let me see thy vengeance upon them, for to thee have I committed my cause. The word of the Lord. Our response, Lord God, I take refuge in you. Lord God, I take refuge in you. From my pursuer, save me and rescue me, lest he tears me to pieces like lion and drags me off with no one to rescue me. Response, Lord God, I take refuge in you. Give judgment for me, Lord. I am just and innocent of heart. Put an end to the evil of the wicked. Make the just stand firm. You test my mind and heart, O just God. Response. God is the shield that protects me, who saves the upright of heart. God is a just judge, slow to anger, but he threatens the wicked every day. Response. Gospel acclamation. Kindly repeat. I will arise and go to my Father.
I will arise and go to my Father.
And I will say to him.
And I will say to him.
Father.
Father.
I have sinned against heaven and before you.
I have sinned against heaven and before you.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. John. Chapter 7, verses from 40 to 52. Some of the people in the crowd heard him say this and said, "This man is really the prophet." Others said, "He is the Messiah." But others said, "The Messiah will not come from Galilee." The scripture says that the Messiah will be a descendant of King David and will be born in Bethlehem, the town where David lived. So there was a division in the crowd because of Jesus. Some wanted to seize him, but no one laid a hand on him. When the guards went back, the chief priests and the Pharisees asked them, "Why did you not bring him?" The guards answered, "Nobody has ever talked like this man." "Did he fool you too?" the Pharisees asked them. "Have you ever known one of the authorities or one Pharisee to believe in him? This crowd does not know the law of Moses, so they are under God's curse." One of the Pharisees there was Nicodemus, the man who had gone to see Jesus before. He said to the others, "According to our law, we cannot condemn a man before hearing him and finding out what he has done." "Well," they answered, "are you also from Galilee? Study the scriptures and you will learn that no prophet ever comes from Galilee." The Gospel of the Lord. In today's Gospel, the preaching of Jesus caused a division among the people. Some looked up to him as the prophet and the Messiah, but others resented and opposed him. The Gospel always creates a division. But the mistake is with the recipients. How they receive the message and understand the meaning behind every word of the scripture. As a good medicine may ripen, the diseased, the tumor, in order to discharge the pus. And let us note what the gospel passage wants to convey to us today. Some people thought highly of Jesus. Some who listened to Jesus' preaching and witnessed his miracles, his authoritative interpretation of the scriptures, inviting sinners for repentance, welcoming so many outcasts of the society, and healing so many sick people, and so many were affected by the words and works of Jesus Christ. Some among them said, "He was the prophet." And these people saw in Jesus the fulfillment of the Mosaic prophecy. Hearing the words of the Lord and seeing his works and his miracles, the multitude thought that Jesus is the true prophet. And some people even went ahead and proclaimed Jesus as the Messiah, the Anointed One. Some people were prejudiced against Jesus. No sooner was Jesus acknowledged by some of the people as the Christ, others objected their view and opposed to Jesus. Their one argument to refute Jesus' claim of being the Messiah was that he was from Galilee. No prophet, they claimed, had ever come from Galilee, and surely the Messiah. And they said he was not the expected Messiah. And the ones who were prejudiced against were right in quoting the scriptures about the Messiah lineage and the birthplace, but they were greatly mistaken in thinking that Jesus was not from the stump of Jesse. They were not interested at least to find out from the genealogy of David or from Jesus himself or from his mother who actually Jesus was. Little learning of scriptures sometimes is very dangerous. With half knowledge, we cannot correctly interpret the words of the gospel or the scriptures. And many a times we are misled by half knowledge of the scripture, not only ourselves, but also we mislead the people around us. And that exactly happened in the case of these people. With the half knowledge of the scriptures, they were misleading and misinterpreting the words of the scriptures, and they were misleading the people. And we need to always ask for the wisdom and knowledge, especially in the scriptures, so that we may understand the words of the scriptures and the word that Jesus uttered, and really understand and meditate upon these words and then translate into action. And we need to convince ourselves first and then convince others. And today let's pray in this Holy Mass that we may have the true knowledge of every word of God and every word of the scriptures, that the scriptures may transform us and thus we may transform others.
For offertory, please take hymn number 189.
Accept, O my divine, these gifts of bread. For us before thy shrine.
brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept his sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for all the good and good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, we pray, with these oblations you receive from our hands, and even when our wills are defamed, constrain them mercifully to turn to you through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, for you will that our self-denial should give you thanks, humble our sinful pride, contribute to the feeding of the poor, and so help us imitate you in your kindness. And so we glorify you with countless angels, as with one voice of praise we acclaim,
Holy, 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 Holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Tumabal, our Archbishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And we pray for late Kannappa Joseph, Dayalamma and Velankani, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father, Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your Church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, who take away the sins of the world, grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you shall enter into my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
Sanctify me, body of Christ, save me, blood of Christ, inebriate me, water from the side of Christ, wash me, passion of Christ, strengthen me, O good Jesus, hear me, within thy wounds hide me, suffer me not to be separated from thee. From the malignant enemy defend me. At the hour of my death call me, and bid me come to you, that with your saints I may praise thee for all eternity. Amen. Prayer of Pope Francis for the Jubilee. Lord Jesus Christ, you have taught us to be merciful like the Heavenly Father, and have told us that whoever sees you sees him. Show us your face, and we will be saved. Your loving gaze freed Zacchaeus and Matthew from being enslaved by money, the adulteress and Magdalene from seeking happiness only in created things, made Peter weep after his betrayal, and assured paradise to the repentant thief. Let us hear, as if addressed to each one of us, the words that you spoke to the Samaritan woman. If you knew the gift of God, you are the visible face of the invisible Father, of the God who manifests his power above all by forgiveness and mercy. Let the Church be your visible face in the world, its Lord risen and glorified. You will that your ministers would also be clothed in weakness, in order that they may feel compassion for those in ignorance and error. Let everyone who approaches them feel sought after, loved, and forgiven by God. Send your Spirit and consecrate every one of us with its anointing, so that the Jubilee of Mercy may be a year of grace from the Lord, and your Church, with renewed enthusiasm, may bring good news to the poor, proclaim liberty to captives and the oppressed, and restore sight to the blind. We ask this through the intercession of Mary, Mother of Mercy, you who live and reign with the Father and the Holy Spirit, forever and ever. Amen. For the intentions of our Holy Father, our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from all evil.
Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now in the hour of our death. Amen.
Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
Let us pray. May your holy gifts purify us, O Lord, we pray, and by their working render us fully pleasing to you, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Mass is celebrated. Let us go and serve the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
For the final hymn, please take hymn number 472. 472.